Dear students, welcome and thank you for tuning in to this video with me, Dr. Alzube. We are still talking about the moment of a couple. So in the previous video, we defined what a couple is, what is an equivalent couple, and we talked about determining the moment of a couple, and we talked about finding or determining the resultant couple moment. We're going in this video to solve an example that hopefully is going to show all these concepts in action. So this is our problem that we're going to solve. So given two couples, you can see that we have a couple, right, which is the 50 pound. So there are two 50 pounds equal in magnitude and opposite in direction. And I have another also 80 pound force going in that direction and an opposite equal force in the opposite direction. So I have two couples. So these two couples act on this beam with the geometry shown. We would like to find the resultant couple. So if you remember from the previous video, our couples are free vectors, so we can use vector analysis to add them together. So our plan in solving this problem will be as follows. First, we need to resolve the forces in x and y direction. This is a two-dimensional problem, so that they can be treated as couples and see how they will look like, because we would like to find the distance that is perpendicular between the forces. And then we're going to add these couples to find the resultant couple. So how is this going to be done? First, we are going to work on the couple on the top right hand of our image, the 50 pound. So I know that the distance between the two forces is 3 feet. So as we talked before, we'd like to find the component in the x and y direction. So if I look at this first force, this force can be resolved into a component in the x direction here, and a component on the y direction going up, correct? So if you want to do this, we have this angle 30 degrees, and if I'm going to resolve this force on this axis, the y-axis, since the angle is off that axis, I'm going to do the cosine. So this is going to be 50 cosine 30, right? That's what we want to have. And in the one here is going to be 50 sine 30. So this is 50 and sine 30. Same thing should happen for the other force. So I'll have a component here on the x-axis and a component going down for the y-axis. So the component here on the x-axis, since it's not, so the angle is not off that axis, this is going to be 50, the one on x here. I'm going to write it up there. Right, so it's going to be 50 sine 30. And the one down is 50 cosine 30. And then I resolve the forces into x and y component. If you can notice that the one with the cosine, it's going, so 50 cosine 30 is 43.3 pounds vertically, and horizontally is going to be 25 pounds to the right for this one here. If the question is, do both of these components, the x and y component, form a couple? The answer to that is no. Because this 50 going to that direction, 50 sine 30, and the other one 50 sine 30, they cancel each other and there is no distance between them. So I don't have a D between the two forces. They are on top of each other. So they're on the same line. So there's no, that D is equal to zero. And if you remember, the moment equals F multiplied by D. So for the one, the horizontal ones, my D is equal to zero. So that's F multiplied by zero, and that's zero. So I don't have any moment on the X because of the x components. So the only couple I have is the 50 cosine 30. So it's the vertical component here. So this is to just show the answer. No, only the 43.3, which is the vertical component going up and going down, creates a couple. And why? The reason, because the x component here, the distance is zero, so my moment is just zero. No, I don't have a moment for that couple. I'm going to do the same for the other one, the 80 pounds. But if I want to find the moment of the couple that I have, which is the 43 you know that the M1 is going to equal the force multiplied by the distance, and your force is 50 cosine 30, and you multiply it by the distance, which is 3 feet. That's your first couple. Remember that we always assume counterclockwise as the positive, and if you look at the direction of the motion, the vertical forces, they're trying to tend to rotate clockwise, right? So that's negative. So that value is going to be negative. And all of this, the unit, is going to be pound multiplied by feet. I hope that clarifies this. All right, now for the second one, we're going to do the same. You first resolve the force into x and y component. So this force is going to be resolved on one, the x-axis, which is 80. And if you see these triangles, we can use the trigonometry. And so to do the projection, you take the parallel to this axis divided by the hypotenuse. So 4/5. And the component on the y-axis going down here is going to be 80, right? Let me write it here. So that's going to be 80, and the parallel 3/5, the hypotenuse, correct? Now, same thing goes for the other one. I'm going to have a force projected here, right? And a force going up. So one on the x and one on the y. The one on the x, the horizontal is going to be 80. And again, the parallel over the hypotenuse, 4/5. And this one here is going to be 80, 3/5. Again, notice that these two components, the vertical components, they are equal in opposite direction, and also they are on the same line. So I don't have a D. So my D is 0. So we don't have a couple moment because of these. The only couple moment that is created is because of the 80 multiplied by 4/5 with the horizontal components. And if you do this, this is acting to the right and to the left. So that's the component that creates the couple in this structure. So the net, so this moment from the from the horizontal component, we can say that M2, which is the 80, is equal F multiplied by D, and my force is 80 multiplied by 4/5. And the distance D, as it was given, is 4. And again, this is how the notation is, the rotation, the sense. Counterclockwise is positive. If you look at these two forces, it's turning this way. So it's turning counterclockwise, so that is positive. And that's what you have here, the 46 multiplied by 4. And this is from the previous analysis of the force on the top, the couple on the top. And if you add, it's negative because it's clockwise. If you add them together, you get 126. And you do the multiplication and you add, add them together, 126 feet multiplied by pound. And this is counterclockwise because it's positive. The result is positive. And that's how you solve a problem with couples. And how can you find the couple moment, the resultant couple moment in this example. I hope that clarifies the process. Make sure that you have resolved your components, if it's in two dimensions, in X and Y, and make sure that you know which component is creating the couple. If there are two forces equal and opposite in direction, but on the same line, I don't have a distance. The distance is zero, so they're not going to create a couple or a moment for us. That's it for now, and thank you, and till the next video. Bye.